Hello, I'm William Short of Hurstwic, and this is another in our series of Viking combat sparring videos. If you haven't watched the first video in this series, I recommend that you watch it now, since it explains our sparring conventions. In our Viking combat training at Hurstwic, we often set up historical Viking Age battle situations, as described in the sagas of Icelanders, and then we fight them to experience as closely as possible Viking Age fight situations. Sometimes we set up these fight situations outdoors and spar, but more often we spar indoors in our training room. When we spar indoors, we often capture video of the fight using three cameras. We use a small camera attached to the fencing mask of the two opposing fighters to capture the fight from their points of view. In addition, we use a third camera to the side, which captures the view as seen by an outside observer. After the video has been edited, we combine all three video streams in the same frame so that all three views can be seen at the same time. This gives us much more detailed information about our performances. Instead of using the three-hit rule as we commonly do when we spar outdoors, we continue fighting until the end of the round, regardless of the hits. One of the reasons we do this is because in a fight, one never knows whether a hit would take a combatant out of the fight or not. And so we simply continue fighting until the round timer signals the end of the round. The scenario we will be showing you is an indoor fight under a low ceiling, a situation mentioned in the sagas. Viking Age longhouses typically did not have ceilings, but they did have low beams and low rafters which supported the roof. A weapon could easily get caught in one of these wooden beams or rafters if a fighter were not careful, something that happened in indoor fights described in the sagas. Additionally, a smaller longhouse, such as Eriksstadi, the Viking Age house of Erik the Red, did not have a lot of interior room in which fighters could maneuver. We simulated the low ceiling with tarps hung overhead at a low level. We simulated the small room by having people stand around the periphery of the tarps to push fighters back into the room if they strayed too far. This is a crude simulation of training in a Viking house with real weapons, but it was good enough that we felt confined and entrapped in many of the same ways as that described in the sagas. And so here, a Viking Age fight in a longhouse with a low ceiling. The round was chaotic, but it shows the need to adapt to surroundings. The confined space made many of our usual sparring moves disastrous. The confined space also required intense situational awareness. Was a step to the rear or to the side possible at any given moment? Was a high attack possible, or would the weapon get caught in the ceiling? This awareness changed how the combatants fought in this situation. Matt grabbed and controls Corey's weapon repeatedly, a move described in the sagas and one that was disastrous for Corey. In the resulting struggle, Corey was sometimes able to disarm Matt and take away his weapon, which resulted in several exchanges of weapons. This drill exposed us to conditions we don't normally see in our sparring, requiring us to adapt our fighting moves and our tactics on the spot to the new situation. That's a valuable skill for a fighter, and a skill we want to exercise in these kinds of sparring drills.